Hey guys, I just wanted to give you a demonstration for this assignment of designing a garment in 3D using pre-made blocks. So this should be pretty easy to handle. I know CLO is new for a lot of you guys in this class, so I think this is a good way to kind of introduce yourself to the software, and I hope you guys really like it. I know you've been working a lot in Illustrator, and we pull blocks and redesign garments all the time in Illustrator. It's kind of a similar concept as well, but in 3D. So you need to get the software on your computer, and then once you do, you might want to just double check that everything's downloaded, especially for the students that have been using CLO in other classes. There might be some folders that you haven't used in a while. I'm on a Mac, and to help save memory, it'll put them on the cloud. So you want to go to your CLO assets folder and just see how there's like a cloud by avatar. That means not all the avatars are downloaded. I'm going to double click this avatar. I'm going to click avatar again. You can use either the female or the male avatar, totally up to you, but you're going to be using the V2, which I think stands for version 2, because I'm going to use the female one. There is a modular avatar, and we're going to be using that avatar for this assignment. So you want to make sure there's no cloud by that folder. I had to go in and re-download it, so that's why I'm making a big point about this. So my cloud is gone. I'm good. Open the software, go to library. Again, you might even have to download it up here as well if you're not finding it. So, okay, so we're going to open up the avatar. Here it is. I'm going to double click avatar. Again, you have to use either version 2 female or version 2 male. I'm going to do female, so I'm going to double click it. And then here we are. So you should see avatar modular. If you don't, that's why I was explaining what I was just explaining. Okay, so I'm going to double click the modular, and we have all these different avatars to choose from. I'm just going to pick the top one. You guys can pick anyone your heart desires. Okay, we'll wait a minute for it to load. Okay, cool. So I don't really need the library right now, so I can close my library. So there's like a little arrow right here, and then that way I get a little bit more room on my screen. And we're going to design a 3D garment with blocks that are already drafted. They're already sewn together. So you don't really need to know 3D software, thank God, as well. So this should be pretty easy for you guys. So this tool that is in CLO, it's called Modular Configurator. So click that tabs over on the left. So these are the garments that come with the software. You know, it's really not that many garments, but hey, it's definitely better than none. I think if you really get into designing this way, you'll want to build out your own library or work with a team that could help you. There's probably resources online that you could buy more blocks if you wanted. But I imagine if you work for a company, they work pretty hard to establish like the perfect fit, you know, and then they start calling that their block. Maybe it's a t-shirt, maybe it's pants, maybe it's a woven shirt, whatever it is. And so it's just nice to have these like approved fits ready to go, and you can start with those fits and then redesign them however it is. So if you're a designer, you know, you're probably changing the color, maybe you're adding details, you're adding like prints or even like ruffles or extra stitching. Maybe you are changing the silhouette a little bit, some kind of variation, making it longer, adding some flare or fullness or whatever. But it's a really cool feature. Okay, so what you're going to do for this assignment, choose a shirt. So let's see here. I'm in blocks. I'm clicking up here, back to blocks. I think mine was already open. I'm going to double click this folder. Okay, so for women, I actually have all these choices, jackets, polo, shirts, t-shirts, and trench coat. No bottoms, doesn't come with CLO, but you can definitely save your own blocks if you wanted to. I'm just going to go something simple. I'm going to choose t-shirts. You guys can choose whatever you want. There's two different style of groups, like a satin sleeve versus dropped. I'm going to do dropped, so I'll double click it. And then now you're going to see all the patterns that are available in this group. It looks like I have 5 different bodies to choose from and 2 different sleeves. So I'll just pick this middle one, and then I'm going to do the short sleeve. So I just double clicked it. Okay, I'm done. I can close this menu, get more space. And right off the bat, you can see I have a t-shirt. I want to look around it. So again, if you're new, you want to hold the right clicker on your mouse, and you can kind of just rotate around and kind of check it out and see what it looks like. So voila, I have a t-shirt garment. Here's my pattern, I'm ready to go. But for this assignment, I am making you change it just a little bit. It's up to you how much you want to change it. I know some of you guys are more experienced. In that case, go crazy, do whatever you want. If this is your first time, I'll walk you through some of the basic tools you'll need to know. So first of all, to scroll, you can zoom in and out, right click, you know, you can view around. So in the 2D pattern, probably the tool you're going to use the most is the letter Z. I'm going to click Z right now. And you'll see this little tool was highlighted. This will edit just part of your pattern. So you can select just part of it. So for example, I want to make it longer. I'm going to turn this into a dress. So I can click one part of the pattern and then I can click and drag and make it longer, right? There it is. Okay. And then to see what it looks like in 3D, I can simulate and then it'll update it in the 3D window. So to simulate, you'll hit spacebar. There we go. And you kind of give it a minute to kind of figure out what's going on. Okay, so it's kind of funny because I have some sewing stitches. It's telling to sew it to the shorter side. So that's why we're getting some gathers here. That's not really what I want. There's different ways to change it and I'll show you how. So I'm gonna stop simulating. That's important to do because it does use up a lot of your memory. So when you're done, you should stop, especially if you're gonna make more changes. I like hitting spacebar, but you can also hit this blue arrow up here to stop the simulation. Okay, so let's see here. So a few things. You should probably know a little bit about the sewing tools. You don't have to sew it together. It's already sewn together for you, but there is an edit tool to change things. So it's a little sewing machine right here. It has this little white arrow. And that's a reoccurring theme you're going to see in CLO is whenever there's a white arrow, it means you can edit that tool. So I'm going to click this guy and now we can see our sewing stitches. So you can see we're trying to sew a longer piece of fabric to a shorter one. So you can just click and drag and change it. The blue dot that pops up, it's going to say, hey, did you want the seams to be the same length? So you'd probably want it to that blue dot. And then we could do the other side as well. And now we can simulate again to see what that looks like. So spacebar. So there you go. So now we don't have the gathers, but we have a longer side on the front only and not the back. Okay. I'm going to hit Command Z a few times. Okay. Another way to lengthen your garment is, again, use the Z tool because that can edit just part of the pattern. Select the bottom hem. You can hold shift and you can also select the other one. So that way when you click and drag, you're doing at least both of them at the same time and then release. If you want to have more control, you could even select the side seam and then right click and you can say change length. And then you could tell it, yeah, I want you exactly 27 inches. I'm just going to say cancel. And you could do that to the other side to make sure it's also 27 inches. You can also select just a point. I was selecting the line, but you don't have to select the whole line. You can select just the point and bring that out if you wanted to add fullness. These pieces are mirrored pieces, so they're going to stay symmetrical. So if you make a change to one side, it'll automatically change the other side. That's just the way that they've been set up. There we go. And then now I'll simulate to see what that looks like. I'm going to hit spacebar. So yeah, so you can redesign your block into anything you want. Let's see here. Is there any funny business happening? I'm using the hand tool to kind of pull it out a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna let it think about it. It's kind of readjusting right now. What is going on? Do I have a funny sewing tool happening? No, it's just kind of stuck. I think my computer's a little slow. Another great keyboard shortcut I should probably tell you guys is the numbers to help you view. So if you like just get lost in like outer space somewhere or whatever, you can hit the number 2 and it just brings it center front. 4 is the side, 6 is the other side, and 8 is the back. And then like 7 and 5 and 3 are different views as well. So when in doubt, it's always nice to hit the number 2. Also, panning can be really helpful. So like right now I'm zoomed in, but I don't want to zoom in right here. Maybe I want to go up higher by the sleeve. If you push your scroll wheel, you should be able to click and drag and move where you want. For some reason on my Mac, that doesn't work. I have to hold option, but check your user settings and see which way works for you. But I would definitely try to figure out how to pan. It'll give you a lot more control as you work on this assignment as well. I'm gonna hit the number two. So when you're done, I want you to take a snapshot of your 3D pattern and the 2D pattern. I wanna see what the patterns, what shapes they look like to create your 3D one. So you need to share both in our discussion board. How to do that? You're gonna go and do a snapshot. So go up to File, let's see here, and you will say Snapshot. Definitely want one of the 2D patterns, so we can click that to start with. There's lots of different settings. You know, you can show whatever you want. Just make sure I can see the patterns here. You know, there's like, this is just the lines. It's probably good to have the patterns. I don't really care too much. Just hit save. It's going to ask you where you want it saved. What do you want to call it? So I'm going to let you decide. Just don't forget so that you can upload it, and I'll hit save. You'll notice it's a PNG file. That's great. Okay, then we also need to save a snapshot of the 3D window, and I'll show you how to do that in just a second. Here we go, File. Okay. Uh-oh, my computer's slowing down today. There we go, File. Snapshot, 3D window. This one starts off with naming it right away. So let's do 3D view. And remember, don't forget to note where you save it. And let's see here. Your window might open up to the single tab. So you can just say, how big do you want it? Do you want this on a letter size paper? Do you want it portrait view? Or do you want it landscape view? Do you want a transparent background? And it'll just do a snapshot of what is in your 3D window. If you click on multi-view, you have even more choices. You can choose like how many views do you want. You know, right now mine's set at 4. You can make it less. And it's kind of neat because it has some presets here. So you can get the front. Maybe you want a 3/4 view. Maybe you want to zoom in on something in particular in your garment. So like really get in that there. An angle you really want, you can set it in your 3D window and then go over here and click the camera and then it'll copy it, which is kind of neat. So this is just very helpful. And then go ahead and just click save once you're done. And then you'll have all your PNGs to go ahead and embed in our discussion board to share with the class. All right, guys. Looking forward to seeing what you guys come up with designing a garment with these blocks. As always, if you have questions, reach out, let me know.